Day program. This year, the 5th and 6th graders are presenting a performance. We would like to extend a special welcome to all the veterans and their families who are attending tonight's performance.
We are honored to have the Minneapolis VFW Post presenting the colors and as special guests.
Please rise for the color presentation and remain standing for the Star Spangled Banner and Pledge of Allegiance.
Thank you. North Ottawa County students. Middle school teachers are some of the most well-rounded teachers in the schools. Not only are they challenged with managing the excitement and energy of the middle level student, but the social inconsistencies that these students typically have. In the classroom, she is constantly keeping her students active with engaging labs and activities that keep the kids motivated. She utilizes the most current technology available to her to keep the students engaged. Her expectations are high, and she has no problem calling a parent when the student's homework is incomplete to hold them accountable, but is willing to work during her planning time or after school with them for competition. As a teacher in the junior senior high school building, she takes leadership roles and has planned day trips for the entire junior high. She will line judge a volleyball tournament, watch a basketball game, whenever she can find to make a connection with one more student. This year, as community service is a focus for our district, she organized the eighth grade class to work in the Minneapolis Community Garden. The students spent an afternoon working on weeding, winterizing, and cleaning up the beds. Without her stepping up, the space may have been lost for 2017. The auxiliary to BFW Post 3201 is pleased to present the Smart Maker BFW National Citizenship Teacher Award to Linda Willoughby.
Thank you.
Open Time is a song honoring our armed forces. Please stand when your military branch is recognized. The order of the song is Army, Air Force, Navy, Marines, and Coast Guard.
Thank you. Coast Guard, give a hand.
Off the Coast Guard, give a hand.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Once again, I am honored to represent the VFW Auxiliary Post 3201 in Minneapolis, all veterans, and especially our Ottawa County veterans, as we make our fourth annual Veterans Quilt presentation. We would like to thank the staff of the Minneapolis Grade School for allowing us to be here tonight and for the students for allowing us to be part of the program. And we want to say a special thank you to the little kids that helped pass out the pencils. Tonight, the VFW Auxiliary would like to honor 11 of our Ottawa County veterans. As I read your name, if you would come forward, we will present you with your quilt. Jake Kelly. Mr. Kelly served in the Army between 1967 and 1973, and served in Vietnam. Bill Warlock. Mr. Warlock served in the Army, 1968 to 1970 in Vietnam. His quilt was made by Wanda Robbins, and his grandson Camden Robbins will help present it to him. Baltimore, Maryland, in the Counterintelligence Corps. His quilt was made by his niece, Joy Johnson, and she will help present it to him. Sorry, I'm going to be the exception because I want to say a few words. I just want to thank the ladies who work on these quilts. They do incredible amount of work and hours that they put on these quilts every year, and I have the privilege of quilting some of them, so I've seen a lot of their beautiful work. I also have to say something about my uncle. On November 30th, 1967, he was in a boat. He was the commander. I'll probably get some of this wrong because I didn't take speech and I have it here, but I can't read it. He was an officer in charge of a boat that was sent into the river to rescue some Vietnamese, and there were high winds, 25 knots, with swells up to 15 or 18 feet, and his ship boat capsized. Only one person stayed on, and he rescued the Vietnamese fishermen and all the people on his boat he was in charge. There was very little or none loss of life, and he received a medal for his work on that. So this quilt that I did tonight is in recognition of that, because at the same time his wife was having, on the same day, an emergency appendectomy in the States, and she was pregnant and went into premature labor and gave birth to their daughter Cindy. So my quilt, the name of it is Non Sibis Sed Patre, which means not for self, but for country. Thank you. And he was stationed in Mississippi, Texas, Louisiana, and the Philippines. Yeah.
Sam served in the Air Force from 1944 to 19... Oh, I'm so sorry. We may have to make you a new pillowcase. Army, excuse me, 1944 to 1946. Okay, it's right, I'm wrong. He served in World War II in France and Germany. The other was Nick Dolliff. He was in the Army National Guard from 1957 to 1965. And tomorrow morning we will be presenting these to them in their homes. Help me give them another thank you by a round of applause to all of our veterans. Thank you.
You may be seated. they're being really careful because they kept saying, we get to keep these, right? I said, yeah, you get to keep these. They're really happy and thank you. They have a very big heart for you. We all do. And we're so proud and honored to have you here tonight. And love singing for you. And this song is with Mr. Baller, incredibly talented band director. He's going to play trumpet with us on Boogie Woogie Bugle Boy.
For your dedication to this great country. Today you serve as examples that your children and grandchildren strive to imitate.
We need to live by which the spirit our, by which our nation's veterans have so nobly served. The spirit of courage. The spirit of honor. The spirit of America. Please stand for the colors being retired.
To perform for you. We've had a mighty bunch of help to get tonight to ready to go, and I want to say that if you had hashtag Ottawa County Kansas and find out some interesting things, do that. And a lot of things will pop up. We live in a rich history in this place in the world, and have a happy Veterans Day, and thank you for coming tonight. Good night.